Hey everyone, I'm learning to use the field system as my primary way of making music and as my primary gear. I'm going to be making videos to share tips and tricks that I learn along the way. First of all, huge shout out and thank you to Tobias and the rest of Teenage Engineering for sending me, honestly, an unbelievable amount of gear, and I'm excited to use it and share what I learned with everybody. So some of the videos are going to be like deep dives, like I kind of tend to do with the OPZ, but this is just going to be a pretty quick tip for the CM15 microphone. So I have my CM15 here and it is on. I'm going to turn the power switch off and then I'm going to connect it to my OP1 field through this USB-C cable. It's going to take it a second, but it's actually going to still recognize it as a USB audio client and it's going to start picking up the audio from it. So I'm able to use this even if the power switch is on, and once it's connected I can turn it on or off. One of the big benefits is that I don't have to worry about my CM15 running out of battery after I turn off my field if it's connected to that. Because if I forgot to turn it off, then normally that would be a problem because it would just be on and it'd be draining its battery the whole time, but it wouldn't be receiving any charge because the field's off. But if I have this setting enabled, I can just keep it off all the time and not even turn it on if I'm using it as a USB microphone. So let me show you where to change the setting in the update utility. So one quick note I forgot to mention earlier is that because the CM15 is a USB audio client, it's not going to work with the original OP1 or with the OPZ because those require a USB audio host and the CM15 can't do that. So I just opened up the Teenage Engineering Update utility in Chrome and I'm going to go ahead and turn my CM15 on. So I'll wait for the update utility to detect it and then I'm going to hit this settings button up here. At this point, I have two settings to choose from, and we're going to be focusing on the USB charge mode setting. If we disable this setting, we'll be able to use the CM15 as a USB audio client, even if the power switch is off. The good news is that disabling this setting doesn't actually disable charging. It'll still charge, and it'll appear as an audio interface if the power switch is off. So I'm going to disable it, and it takes effect immediately. So I'm going to go ahead and actually turn the power switch off on this CM15. It's off now, but it's still connected to this utility. However, if I go back to settings here, and then I turn this back on, it will actually immediately disconnect the CM15 because it changes the setting.
Okay, so I hope that this video helped. I'm going to continue sharing stuff as I learn how to use this gear and practice different workflows. But until then, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.